Hi, sweetie. How are you? How's the new condo?
Hi, Auntie. I love it. But I called because I remembered you're on your condos board.
Yeah, I still am. What's going on?
Could you tell me about maintenance fees? I've been getting all kinds of info and it's confusing. Aren't those fees for pool cleaning and stuff?
Right. But stuff actually covers a lot of things. When you buy a condo, you automatically become a member of an association of unit owners, and every owner must pay a monthly assessment which covers both the association's current expenses and its reserves. The amount of an owner's monthly assessment, or maintenance fee, is based on their percentage interest in the common elements. Owners are responsible for paying their share of the common expenses, like groundskeeping, trash collection, pool maintenance, and security.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff. But what if I don't use the pool? My maintenance fee will be lower, right?
Nope, sorry. Owners are required to pay their monthly maintenance fees whether or not they use the pool or any of the facilities.
Oh, okay. So what are reserves then?
Reserves are funds saved and set aside for future repairs and replacement of common elements that will cost more than $10,000. This could be roofs, elevators, paving, pipes, painting.
So how does the association know what my percentage interest is?
It's in the governing documents.
What else should I know about maintenance fees?
Find out when payments are due and what happens if you pay late. And it's important to know that maintenance fees generally go up every year, since the cost of utilities, repairs, and other services goes up every year just like everything else. The association notifies owners every year about any increase.
What if I don't agree with the monthly assessments or the increases? I can't be forced to pay, can I?
Sorry, you do have to pay. Hawaii condo law has a pay first, challenge later provision. It says something like, no unit owner shall withhold any assessment claimed by the association. So while you may not agree with an assessment, the law is clear. Owners must pay first. Later, they can try to resolve it using any of the dispute resolution options that are available. Make sense?
Yeah, I'm starting to get it now. Come to think of it, one of my coworkers lives in an older building. She had to pay big bucks because one of the elevators completely broke down.
Yeah, that happens. Older projects often have large expenses for aging stuff like elevators and plumbing. Associations are supposed to have gradually built up adequate reserves, but if not, the board may impose a special assessment, which is an additional fee to cover larger unforeseen expenses, like aging pipes, disaster cleanup, lawsuits, or unexpected expenses.
Can't an association just take out a loan?
That's one way, if the owners consent and the association qualifies. If they don't, then the board must cover the cost somehow, which is often a one-time special assessment on all owners. But if the association votes to borrow money, maintenance fees will be higher for the life of the loan. Sometimes associations do both, so it makes sense for owners to minimize the need for special assessments by reporting any damage they see right away. And check out the Real Estate Branch website for more information, and watch their other videos about condos in Hawaii.
I'm so glad we talked. Now I know a lot more. Thanks again for your help, Auntie. I'll talk to you later.
Okay, take care. Bye, sweetie.